longer things of science fiction movies. They are now a reality, and they are actually not as new as some might think. In fact, the first microchip implants actually date back to the tail end of the 1990s. This week on In Question, host Manila Chan was joined by legal and media analyst Lionel, who says these chip implants might only be the beginning, and it might be a good idea to maintain a healthy level of skepticism about them.
Stockholm has some 4,000 young people who already have these implanted into their hands. They're saying, you know, they have stuff like their LinkedIn profiles loaded into the chip so they can, you know, go to a gala or whatever and just scan each other. And then here, you have my contact information. I mean, as you always say, what can go wrong? I mean, isn't this a quicker way to, you know, rather than having to remember, oh, this is Lionel, this is Manila.
How about this? Stockholm syndrome? Coincidence? I don't know. But let's talk about this. Let's assume eventually I'm able to hack this. And you do this with your children and your dog and your family one day because you want to be able to monitor your children. No more Megan alerts,
but
because
Lionel.
I know where my...
Biohacks argues that by implanting this into your hand, into your skin, it's less hackable somehow than, I don't know, you know, wearing an RFID blocker, you know, wallet in your back pocket, that this thing in your hand would be less hackable.
I'm going to use a terrible pun. God forbid that everybody notices that this chip, let's say, is put on our... And by the way, this is called the Perlicue. Let's say it's put in there.
Okay.
One day, can you imagine some kidnapper hacking, removing this chip? This is a terrible use of the word. But let me also say, we're going to go into it, and then what if these are able to secrete information? What if they're able to leave things? What if you are never able to take them up out? What if they become a part of you? What if through this organic transmogrification, this now, you can take it out, it's there. You are forever branded. And I don't want to wax biblical. I'm certainly not the person to go to. But when they talk about the mark of Cain, and they talk about the, you know, the mark of the Antichrist
all of
and all of
real quickly, you have all of this information stored in your brain. There's a new DARPA project that's been worked on for the last couple of years that you would say transhumanism, you know, what's scary about that word? But DARPA's working on this thing that's going to help your memory. It's it sounds like an external hard drive that somehow helps your memory. Why is this scary?
Because they're going to also implement AI, artificial intelligence, and remember this as being the most frightening, AGI, artificial general intelligence.
All right, there you have it. Microchips for everyone. One for you, one for the puppy, one for grandma. You know, in case you needed a terrifying image as close to Halloween. You can watch In Question Monday through Friday at 12, 1, and 2 p.m. Eastern. And that's it for Just Press Play. We'll see you back here next week. And as always, don't forget to question more.